school, right? So inshallah, everyone, yeah, make intention to practice the deen. Alhamdulillah.
A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Wa tubu ila Allah jami'a ayyuhal mu'minuna la'allakum tuflihun. Honorable ulama, respected brothers, mothers, sisters, beloved youth, not forgetting our honorable Sheikh, Fadilatul Sheikh Abdul Hafiz Makki, Hafidhahullah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. All praise is due to Almighty Allah, the sustainer, nourisher, and cherisher of this universe. Peace, blessings, and salutations be upon our beloved master and leader, Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When I listen to the wonderful words of Maulana Dawood, I think of Shaykhul Islam Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah. When he was incarcerated and imprisoned, his adversaries and people who were envious of him came to him and said, "How's things now in jail?" He read, "Batinuhu fihi rahma wa zahiruhu min qibalihi al-'adhab." You put me in this jail and you thought that you will get away. But yeah, I feel the special mercy of Almighty Allah, although from outside to you it might seem the punishment. When people hear of South Africa, my brothers and sisters in Islam, they associate it with AIDS, they associate it with tick, they associate it with crime. But lest they know that we have the awliyaullah in our midst, in the form of Fadilatul Shaykh Abdul Hafiz Makki Hafidhullah, who has left the Haramain Sharifain to come make i'tikaf with us. Allah's special mercy is on us, my brothers, that Allah chooses our country so that great people came. Hazrat Shaykh Rahmatullah Alayhi Maulana Zakariya Rahimahullah Nawwarallahu Marqadahu. I relate to you one incident. There are many ulama, many students here. Whenever I should teach Maulana Dawood and them hadith, before teaching the hadith, I would always relate this one incident. I said when Hazrat Shaykh Nawwarallahu Marqadahu was in Dawratul Hadith, he and his colleague, they made a pact. They said, "We will listen to every hadith from the teacher in the state of wudu, and we will attend every class, daytime, nighttime." You know, in Dora, the teacher teaches Maghrib time, Isha time, after Fajr. Whenever they attended class and the need arose that maybe the wudu broke, Hazrat Shaykh Nahmatullah Alayhi will just tap his colleague and tell him, pose a question to the Ustad, honorable teacher, teaching a hadith. And quickly they would just go outside, perform wudu and come back. And then while the Ustad is still explaining, so then he would make the wudu and come back. This carried on for months and months, till one Ustad picked it up and said that every time one of them goes outside, the other one asks the question. The love for hadith of Mustafa alayhi salatu salam. Today, now mind the whole world, Indo Park, the Arab world are taking the kitab of Hazrat Shaykh Rahmatullah alayhi and printing it. I saw myself, Hazrat Shaykh's commentary on Abu Dawood, that you find it in the Emirates, printed by the government. Today you take Ojazul Masalik, printed by the Arab governments. So this is Qabuliyat in this world and in the year after, inshallah. So my brothers, my message to you is very, very simple. We heard our youngsters reading the Quran Kareem. Did we hear of Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal rahimahullah? Imam Ahli Sunnah wal Jama'ah? Among his students, it was famous that there was a student who used to read the whole Quran the whole night and complete it. One day he summoned that student of his and said, "Come here. Is it true you complete the Quran every day?" He looked down in respect and said, "Yes." You see, today when you read the Quran, then you must assume and imagine Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal, your teacher, is sitting in front and you read the Quran. The next day when he came, he asked him, "Oh student, how many Jews did you read?" He said, "I only read 10 Jews, 10 paras I read." He said, "Now tonight when you read, you must imagine that Mustafa alayhi salatu salam is there. and you are reading to the Master Habib Allah alayhi salatu wasalam. When he came the second day, he asked him, how much did you read? He said, I read only one juz, O Ustaz. He said, now today, tonight when you read, then think that you're reading directly to Almighty Allah Jalla wa Ala, and then come and tell me how much you read. When the third day he came, crying and weeping in front of his beloved Ustaz, Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal, he said, I could not even complete Surah Fatiha. Brothers, this is love for Quran. When our youngsters read in front of such great ulama, remember me and you, brothers, at that age, maybe on a huzus al briya kenyala. So you must remember, it's being so nervous, and you know it's first time they're reading, maybe. So remember, Almighty Allah bless them, bless their teachers, bless their parents, and everyone, inshallah. Brothers, Almighty Allah Jalla wa Ala has given us another night, 29th night. Whether we are male, whether we're female, alim, non alim, Allah is addressing each one of us. Watubu ilallahi jamia. All of you turn to Almighty Allah in repentance. Ayyuhal mu'minun, O you believers, la'allakum tuflihun, so that you can be successful. Allah is showing us, each one of us has the capacity and ability. When we came here for itikaf, one dua, our fadilatu sheikh, our ustad, our sheikh of this time made, we used to cry. And now Mawlana Dawood made dua, we cried. Everything, my brothers, Allah is showing us, we have the ability, capability. But what happens when Ramadan goes away? Then we go back to our evil, we go back to the devil. Go next to Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal's grave in Iraq. He's buried next to the Tigris River. When the water recedes, then you see his grave. And when the floods come, they even cover his grave. Next to him is Bishr-e-Hafi, that sage of the age. When he used to walk without shoes. When people asked him, oh, Bishr, why do you walk without shoes, rahimahullah? He said, how can I walk with shoes? Wal arda farashnaha fa ni'mal mahidun. That this land and sand, Allah has made it a carpet. I feel shy to walk on the carpet of Allah with shoes and sandals. These were the awliyaullah. For me and you, brothers and sisters, what did he say on the ending of Ramadan? He said, "Bi'sal qawm la ya'rifun Allah illa fi Ramadan." Terrible indeed is a nation who only worships and recognizes Allah during Ramadan. Post Ramadan, we go back to our evil and devil. Al hasana tu ba'd al hasana. To continue with the good deeds is a sign of qabuliyya and acceptance. And a sayya ba'd al hasana. To go back to the evil is a sign of rejection, my brothers. Tonight, beg Almighty Allah for qabuliyya and istiqamah. We beg Almighty Allah for acceptance and steadfastness. Look at Amirul Mu'mineen, Umar bin Khattab radiallahu an. The giant that he was, a person came to him and said, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, tubu ilallahi tawbatan nasuha. He came to Amirul Mu'mineen, Sayyidina Umar radiallahu an, and said, I know what is tawbah, but what is the meaning of nasuha? He said, nasuha is that when you milk the cow, you milk the camel, do you see the milk going back? He said, no. He said, when you say you made tawbah, or human being, or Muslim, or Muslimah, then we don't go back to the vices and the evil. May Allah grant us such a tawbah, inshallah. That is tawbah and nasuha. My last message to you, my brothers. Look at the fadl, the grace, the mercy of Almighty Allah. And Allah sends such honorable personalities to our country, to our city. When we study this world, we see the bounties of Almighty Allah, daytime, nighttime. We go this country, that country. But what did Almighty Allah say? Qul, tell them, O Mustafa alayhi salatu salam, mata'ud dunya qaleel. That the provision and benefits and goods of this world, they are but so few, so little. Allah gives us so much, and Allah calls it qaleel. Me and you, brothers and sisters, we remember Allah Jalla wa Ala 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 1 hour, half an hour. That Allah in His benevolent mercy, that Allah in His infinite grace, what does He call us? وَالذَّاكِرِينَ اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا وَالذَّاكِرَاتِ. We remember Allah little. Allah calls it Zakirin, Allah Kathira wa Zakirat. You remembered me so much, O human being. You love me so much, O human being.